So now in this section, we are going to add one more feature in our application, that is a forgot password or reset password. If user has forgot their password, they can reset it, right? Okay. So almost all the website has this way, right? Has this feature to reset the password, right? Okay. So let's discuss how to write a code for that, right? So let's say user has forgot their password. They will click on the link, right, to reset the password, right? Now, then we will ask user to enter their email ID. And user will enter their email ID, then we will send a mail to the user email, right? And then that mail will have a link by clicking on which user will be navigating to a separate page where they will enter their new password. So this is how things will work, right? Okay. So before implementing this feature, first we need to figure out a way to send email, right? So in this video, we will learn how to send email using Node.js, right? And then we will implement forgot password feature in next video, right? Okay, so let's do that. Okay, so in order to send emails, I'll be using this SendGrid, right? So here you can see we have this free plan, and in this free plan you can send 100 mails per day and forever. So this is a perfect fit for us, right? Okay, so what I can do is I can log in. Where is the login option? Sign in. So I have already created an account, so I will sign into my account. And if you don't have, then you can create a new account in here. So I will log into my account. So I have paused the video and logged into my account, and after logging in, navigate to the settings, and inside the setting navigate to API key. So you need to create an API key in here, right? So now click on this create API. And here, give it a name of, let's say, instagram, Instagram, or my Instagram. Let's say my Instagram, like so. Okay, I will click on this full access, and I will click on this create and view. Okay, now here you can copy your API key by clicking on this. Here you can see copied. Now you should paste this somewhere, right? Let's open route and let's open auth, and maybe in here I can paste the key in here, right? Okay, make sure you use your own key, because I will be deleting this key when I'm done with this video. So yeah, make sure you use your own key, right? Don't use mine. Okay, so we need to install a couple of packages. So here I have opened up my terminal, right, in the server directory. Now I need to install npm install two packages. One is nodemailer node mailer, and another is nodemailer node mailer sendgrid SendGrid and transport, right? So node node mailer, one package is node mailer, another package is node mailer dash SendGrid dash transport, and hit enter. Okay, now let's wait for a few seconds and let these two packages install. And there we go. So now maybe we can start our development server by typing nodemon app to start up our Node.js server. And we need to start React server separately, right? Okay. And there we go. So our Node.js server's running, right? Okay. So let's start writing code. And first we need to initialize some stuff in here. And let's import first nodemon and SendGrid. So first you can type node const node, not nodemon, node mailer, node mailer, node mailer, and require node mailer, and const another thing is SendGrid and transport transport, and that will be again require, and not this require, and SendGrid node mailer SendGrid transport. Okay, like so. And then we need to initialize some stuff here. I can write const transporter, and this will be equal to node mailer and dot create transport, and inside this create transpose we will pass this SendGrid transport, right? Okay, this one, right? SendGrid transport, and inside this SendGrid transport we will pass an object, right? Inside this object we will have a key with auth, with the name auth, and this key will again be an object, and inside this object here we need to pass API slash key, and this will be equal to this one, this API key. Control C, Control V. Or you know what you can do is you can put this key in your dev.js file, right? Because this file contains all the sensitive data. Or we will do it later, right? We will do it later. Okay. So now we can make use of transporter to send the emails. So now let's say when user is getting signed up for the very first time, then we will send user maybe a welcome message to their email, right? So let's have, so yeah, in here. So whenever we are sending a response, right, here we can write a code to write to send a mail to the user, right? If user has successfully signed up, right? So what we can do is we can use transporter, and now here we can call send mail, and inside the send mail we need to pass an object, and an object it will have a to, right? So we want to send a mail to user, right? In this, from this user we have this email, so we have this user record available, from that we can access email, right? And from here we can add from. Now in from you can put whatever email ID you want. Maybe I will put no reply at the rate insta.com. You can put whatever mail ID you want, right? I am putting here no reply because this is an automated email, so user should not reply to this email, right? Okay. And subject will be signup sign up su success, right? And html sign up success, and then put a comma and then html, right? So maybe html will be, let's say, h1 tag and maybe welcome to Instagram, instag Instagram, right? Something like that. Okay, you can put whatever you want, right? Feel free to put whatever you want, right? Okay, subject to from. Okay, now here you can chain on then. Once the email has successfully sent, then in this then you can maybe you can do some stuff. Maybe when the email has successfully delivered, then you can send this response. But you know, this will make our application slow. So yeah, so we will not chain on this then block, right? We don't want to do anything, right? Once the email is sent, right? You can chain on then if you want to do something, some stuff after sending the email, right? Now these two things are independent of each other. This response will not wait for this thing to finish, right? Okay. So yeah. And it's completely fine, right? Okay. We should not wait for this to, right, to finish, and then we should send the response, right? Okay, this is something, this will make our application slow if we will wait for this to finish and then we send response, that this will make our application slow. So these two are independent of each other, right? This response will not wait for this to finish first, right? Okay. Yep. So I think this is it. So let's spin up our React server. So I'll go to this client, and inside this client I will open CMD, and I'll type npm start to open my React server, and let's try this, right? Let's try to sign up a new user, and there we go. So let's sign up a new user. So I have deleted all the users from my database, right? And we are starting with the fresh, right? Okay, so we will start with a fresh user. So maybe we can write name Mukesh, and maybe with the email. Now use your real email, right? As you will not be able to see the mail, right? So use your real email. So I'll use my real mail, that is mukeshphulwani66@gmail.com, and password 12345. Okay, so uploading profile pic is optional, so I can click on the sign up, right? So we should see a kind of a toast message if the user has successfully signed up, saved successfully. Now let's go to my mail ID, right? And I should refresh this, right? Or I should wait for maybe a little bit, some seconds. Here you can see we have got a mail, right? We have got a mail. Amazing. Here we can see no reply insta@rate.com. We have got a mail from no reply insta.com, right? And here we can see welcome to Instagram, right? This is beautiful, right? This was beautiful, isn't it? Right? So this was amazing. Okay. So this is how you can send mails, right? Using Node.js. Okay. So maybe in next video, we will start working on forgot password. So I'll see you guys in the next video.